Ja.
Das möchte ich sehen.
Okay, aber ich fotografiere analog. Ich kann das nicht löschen.
Hi guys, Samuel here. Welcome back to another video. And today we are going to do another POV street photography video, but this time we're going to shoot on film.
Yes!
Yes!
Yeah, no digital cameras today, except for this one, of course. And this is something we always wanted to do. Bello and I, we were talking about it last week and we were too scared to try it, but now is the day and we are finally doing it. And yeah, we will go to Hamburg's biggest amusement park, which is right behind us, and it should be really crowded today because it's Saturday and
good weather.
Yeah, maybe we can even take a roller coaster ride or something like that. But yeah, yeah, let's talk about the cameras we are using. Let's start with your camera, the Nikon F3.
F3, yeah.
The pro camera. Yeah, it has an amazing sound. And you have a 24mm,
yes.
Right? Yeah. And you are going to shoot on expired film.
Yeah.
And what is your film?
My film is a original T-Max.
Kodak T-Max.
Expired on
2004. Yeah, but I really look forward to see how it will turn out. So it's black and white.
Yeah.
And you also shoot black and white.
Yeah.
Yeah. What camera do you use today?
Canon at TL-117, like we saw in the other video.
You have a 40mm, and what is your film?
I have an HP5 inside, the one I showed you last time, and I also have a Pen F. I'm going to try that one today, maybe.
So you're also shooting black and white
only?
And I will be using the camera of my brother. This is the Pentax Spotmatic, and I will be using... I will start with color. I have this cheap Fuji Color C200, and then I really want to try out this one, the Kodak Tri-X 400, which is a really popular film stock. A lot of street photographers love to use this. And yeah, I think we should start to load our film.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Life's easy.
Okay, cameras are loaded.
Yeah.
Are you ready? Let's
We're
go.
Ready. Okay.
Now let me take a minute to thank our sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community for creators with more than 25,000 classes in things like graphic design, filmmaking, photography, business, and lots of other things. You can learn how to play an instrument, for example. There are really useful classes on audio production, video editing, and there are also some street photography classes. My favorite is from Andrew Wagner, who is a street photographer from NYC. And he also teaches how to develop black and white film, which I haven't done before, and I'm really excited to learn that. So definitely check that out. The premium membership gives you unlimited access to all classes for a super affordable price of less than $10 a month. And on a personal note, I just canceled my Netflix subscription. Because if I'm honest, I was wasting too much time watching shit that I don't really enjoy. So why not use that time and improve my channel and learn something new, something useful. So if you are like me and you want to improve your skills, I have a custom link for you in the description. The first 500 people who click on that link will get 2 full months of free trial on Skillshare. So you get plenty of time to try out some classes and start learning some new skills. So thanks Skillshare for supporting my channel. Let's go back to the video.
Ja, das reicht. Ende! Woo!
So we are now in front of the amusement park and the first problem is, what exposure should we choose? So I want to close my aperture because I want to have all in focus. So I will use zone focusing. And my light meter unfortunately is broken or it doesn't work. So there's an app where you can actually do the metering. So this is called the Light Meter app. And I think it's $3 or so. And I will measure for this part here. Okay, so I just measured the exposure and I want to be at f8. So I need a 60th of a second. But this is too slow for me.
Yeah, so I need a 5.6 aperture and 125th of a second shutter speed.
I don't know, I'm not sure. I would think that I need 5.6 too. But yeah. I don't know, because I am trying to go to 125 or 250th of a second.
Okay, do you need the app?
Yeah, give me the app please, so okay. I can check it.
Okay, stop the talking, let's go.
Let's go.
And it's so hard because I have ASA 200 in my camera. I only can shoot a 60th of a second, maybe 125th, and I'm at aperture 3.5 or around 2.8 or 3.5, which is way too open. I want a close aperture, but I can't do it. It's too dark.
Alter, Fuji Chrome, das ist dir.
Okay.
Ich bin wieder bei Farbe.
Okay, short little update. This is not the same day. This is actually a week later. We had to cancel our last shooting day because it was too dark too soon. And our film speeds were too slow. I was shooting 200 and Nikolai was shooting 100. And you had 400.
I had 400, but I couldn't use my 50.
Okay, and now we are back at the amusement park and you actually bought ASA 800 film.
Yes.
So, load it.
See the fail video, huh? Yeah. Okay, ready to rumble.
Let's go.
Finished my roll of Fujifilm C200 and I will now switch to Kodak Tri-X 400. Finally. Oh, it's so cold, my finger. Oh. Yeah. Thank you, assistant. Ta-da! Copyrighted music.
Deleted.
Wait.
I know that feel, bro. 1 hour later.
Yeah. No!
Come on, bro, get it inside. Too many references. Come on, push it.
Push it harder.
Push it real hard. Dun, dun,
dun, dun. Okay. I will close it. I did it all by myself. Okay.
Yeah.
And I'm ready. Okay.
Easy. That's how.
So this is how you do it. Okay. So now I can go down to 5.6 aperture, which means I have a range of maybe 6 meters to maybe 3.5 or 4 meters.
Thank you.
Okay, dann kommen wir nach Hause. Ciao, ciao.
Okay, that's it. That was our analog POV shootout. It was really rough, man. It was so hard. The first day, I think I missed all my shots. We haven't seen them yet.
I think I don't have one image. I don't know. Maybe from the other day, but today, the colored pictures, I don't think I have one.
I want to know if I at least got a sharp image. Yeah. You know, all this, I think everything is blurry because I had to use low shutter speeds. And I think it's 4 p.m. now and it's already dark. So,
yeah.
So yeah, this was for us the first time doing street photography on film. So don't be too hard on us. Let us also know if you want to see more analog film photography.
You know what was hard for me today especially? It was uncomfortable because you don't know and then you can't even argue with somebody of taking pictures or something. Because you don't know what you do and then you feel insecure. So you have to practice some more. Mm.
But you know, I felt more secure because I cannot delete them.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
You know, I was shooting and no one said anything, but if they would say something, I know that at least I got the picture.
Yeah. Okay, that's true, yeah.
Wait a minute.
It actually even happened to me.
Hmm?
That actually even happened to me.
Yeah?
Yeah, somebody was like, hey, you took a picture, and I was like, yeah. And she said, I don't want to delete it, and I said, it's analog, I can't. And then she just went on, like.
Do we get another round?
I think. Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, a short story how we ended up here. Because usually you have to get at least 4 or 6 people in here.
Yeah.
And we actually had to pay 2 tickets each. So 4 tickets just to get here, you know, just by ourselves.
Yeah, so if you want to have more of these videos, please go to his Patreon and send us money
for this channel.
For this wheel of, I don't know how it's called.
Yeah. Okay. No. So, I hope you enjoyed this. See you in the next one. Subscribe, share. Bye bye.
And like.
And like.
Like, better like.